like this to defend yourself. It's a powerful weapon.
This is a pen.
Only use it in times of severe distress.
This is a pen.
Click it. Great.
Well, for me, it was a matter of having obviously lived through the first three Harry Potter films. It was extremely important that we avoided any cinematic comparisons whatsoever. There were some comparisons that I felt that had to be removed from the movie itself. So the movie stands on its own. I was initially attracted to the movie because I thought after working all those days on Potter, I was really not excited about going back to a visual effects movie, a green screen movie. It had to be something really special. And the concept of Greek mythology intertwined with modern, you know, contemporary America was fascinating to me. I'd never seen that film before. So that was my initial excitement about doing the film. That's one of the things I loved about the movie is there is that element of Greek mythology that's extremely dark and complex, that's very, you know, NC-17 rated, and you wouldn't tell those stories to a 10-year-old. And then there's the Classics Illustrated version where the kids learn at school. And obviously we deal with the more Classics Illustrated version, but if you know Greek mythology, when Uma Thurman says, "Son of Poseidon, I used to date your daddy," you know what we're referring to. It came about from me living in London for 4 years, probably the single greatest experience of my life, greatest 4 years of my life, and I miss it terribly. But I would, you know, come home at night after working on the Potter set, and I would watch Alan Partridge. And I fell in love with that character and Steve Coogan's performance because he has the ability to combine comedy and a real sense of darkness. And I thought, well, what a great idea for Hades. So it was just obvious casting. And then Steve brought in the whole rock star element, the combination, as he calls it, between sort of Mick Jagger and David Bowie a little bit. And it was a joy to work with somebody who has that underlying darkness, you know. Well, there's been some talk about the age difference. In the book, they're 11 years old. And I initially couldn't conceive of doing some of these sequences where they basically have to train to become warriors with 11-year-olds and wooden swords. I thought, it's just going to be a little cheesy. What do we do to give those sequences some guts, some depth, some real edge? And when I saw 3:10 to Yuma, Logan Lerman stuck with me because I was really impressed by his performance. So when he came in and did a screen test, essentially really, really affected all of us because here was a kid who was at the time 17, but who embodied this sort of old soul in an odd way. And also his acting instincts and his abilities as an actor were sort of like someone who's been doing it for 40 years. So I was really impressed with him as an actor. And I truly believe he will become one of the great actors, more than just a movie star. Actually, he'll branch out and do a lot of things that'll surprise us. So it was kind of an honor to work with him. So I built the cast around him, trying to find people who had a real sense of chemistry with him. And finding Annabeth was a bit of a challenge because we interviewed a lot of so-called ingenues in Hollywood, and no one there eats anything, so they all weigh about 40 pounds. And I thought, how in God's name am I going to create a warrior who can fight, who looks like she hasn't had a cheeseburger in 10 years? So when Alex came into the picture, I thought, well, here's someone who's a formidable warrior, who appears to be a demigod, and that's why I cast Alex. Tropic Thunder is one of my favorite films of that year, and I saw Brandon in that picture, and I thought, oh, he could be an interesting combination. So I brought Brandon in, Alex, and Logan, and they did another screen test with the three of them, and there was just a tremendous amount of chemistry. And he's a scene stealer, so I spent most of my time on the set telling him to shut up. So I don't want to be presumptuous enough to think that this is going to be, you know, a big franchise. I'm hopeful, but I'm treading very carefully. So if we're fortunate enough that the picture's successful, I would love to work with this cast again. It was just a really thrilling experience, and there are other Greek gods to be cast, and there are other great creatures to bring to life. So.